July 3, 1998, the day that all international disputes were resolved. This day marked the beginning of true peace for the entire world, for people of all races. The four powers quickly formed anti-terrorist organizations and set out creating peacekeeping agencies to bring order and security on a global scale. The world unified to do everything in its power to eradicate all the weeds of evil and disorder. The International Society, under the motto of protecting the world from international terrorism, ideology terrorism, and cyber terrorism, stopped all air transportation and closed every network station in a short span of 2 years to reduce the likelihood of terrorism. The world had changed. In the year 2002, a network of intercontinental expressways bridging the Atlantic Ocean opened, connecting the two major sides of the world. In the following year of 2003, the construction of a mass-scale distribution system began, and a man-made landmass as large as a city was built over an ocean. The use and research of nuclear energy was banned, and all radioactive waste and materials were disposed of at an energy disposal facility in the Gibsoft Islands, a remote set of islands off the coast of the Indian Ocean. Now, international eyes were on the elimination of the intercontinental missiles that posed the biggest threat to world peace. In order to eliminate these weapons of mass destruction, they were launched outside the Earth's atmosphere and intercepted by other missiles, exploding them on contact. People around the world watched these explosions light up the sky as if they were some kind of dazzling light show. These explosions, later known as the missile shows, became the symbol of world peace. The world was filled with hope. But a new threat was on the rise. At the signing ceremony of the UN's World Security Treaty in the year 2003, a new breed of terrorists, who called themselves Smiling Faces, attacked the ceremony. The devastating attack caught the International Society by surprise and temporarily crippled key operations in the United Nations. That assault was aimed at nothing other than using terrorism to create terror. Fear spread throughout the nations like wildfire. There was nothing the police or the military could do to counter the Smiling Faces. The only ones who had any chance of stopping these Smiling Faces were the omniscient and almost godlike professional assassins. The key players behind the scenes of the four powers utilized their connections and called upon the group known as Killer Seven. Their only hope rested with them.
Please leave your message after the tone.
Hello, Mr. Smith. The election is drawing near. Have you decided on your vote? If you haven't, please let the Republic Party make the most of your precious vote. Thank you and have a nice day.
Precious vote? Yeah, right.
What? You want to eat? Make it fast, okay? I have to go to class at 9.
Oh. Arcium, how long has it been?
The Master is awake.
Garcian, relax.
As you wish, Master. There's an important message for you.
Ah, yes, I've felt it. An old friend is trying to bring down a country.
I will contact you.
If there are visitors for me, call.
As you wish.
Samantha, the lights.
As you wish, Master. It's time. Can I go now?
Yeah. Thanks.
See you tomorrow, then. Thanks. Mwah.
This? A bug in the system?
No, sir. It's reading right. There's 200.
What the hell?
A country could disappear off the map.
Do you have the impact point yet?
Yes, sir. It's Japan.
What? Are the fireworks ready?
No, forget it. Japan is our ally.
No, we're not authorized to make that kind of decision.
Forget authorization. We have to do something now or else.
We can't just let it happen.
Get the president on the line.
This is an emergency call for the President. Mr. President, this is Spencer speaking, sir. 200 pulsars have been fired towards Japan. We're unable to compute their trajectory since we're avoiding the computation time lag. Interception can only commence 2 hours before initial impact. Shall we launch the fireworks? Mr. President, your assessment, sir.
The missiles have been launched.
Where are they headed?
Japan.
Washington?
Restaurant Fukushima. It's a popular joint.
And the target?
The owner of the place, Toru Fukushima. See, he's the middleman between the Japanese UN representatives and our government.
A government job?
It's a job from all the parties. Japan has turned against us.
So that's why they're gonna hit Japan?
Well, it's a possibility. It depends on how they move.
It'll be a blow, all right. What will happen to Japan?
It's up to the president. They have 18 hours.
All hell's gonna break loose over in Washington. And I sure as hell don't want to be there.
If, for some reason, you need help, go see a guy named Kasai. He's well-informed, especially about the Japanese movement. You got all the details in there, okay? This time, the string puller is Fukushima. Now, the integrity and the true worth of Japan is at stake here.
Irishamase, welcome. How many in your party, sir?
I want to talk to the owner.
May I ask what it's concerning?
Yeah, I'm here to kill Mr. Fukushima.
Certainly, we'll be delighted to serve you.
Ha 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 ha!
Looks, doesn't it?
I must be a master of the world. work.
Doesn't it? Hurts, doesn't it?
Devil in the silver one, that's the hell of a mess of your towns.
Doesn't it? Hurts, doesn't it?
I am!
Hurts, doesn't it? Doesn't it? Doesn't it? Hurts, doesn't it?
Thank you.
Hurts, doesn't it?
What's in your right hand, Chico?
Please don't. This is just a...
Put your arms down!
No, no, it's not like that. This gun is a...
Don't move, amigo.
Please, don't shoot.
Stay still.
Ow!
What were you doing here?
Cleaning up. Our head chef always tells us that an ideal kitchen is a kitchen clean enough that you can lick the floor. Anyway, it's the least that I can do for them.
The others? The chef? The waiters? Where are they?
Those guys with the strange smiles. You saw them?
It's dangerous, Aki. Get out of here.
Awesome.
Fuck you!
I'm desperate. Get me out of here. Thank you.
We've been expecting you. If you will, right this way, please. Mr. Fukushima is waiting for you inside.
I always wanted to be a tea master. It's one of the reasons I chose this profession.
Which profession may that be?
You're an interesting man when you ask a very difficult question. Perhaps it's a sense of humor that can only come from someone who lives his life on the edge. I wanted to become a politician who could be a true leader, but the world of politics was like a stage where people only acted. They were merely actors playing the politician.
Did you ever think of becoming an actor?
Well, it just so happened that I got a call from the government asking me if I wanted to become an architect for them.
Architect? You mean to design and devise?
Yes. I took the offer with delight.
Is that the only thing you do, Mr. Fukushima, the founder?
Could you bring us some refreshments?
Certainly.
It's a really old story. Union 7, a group made up of seven young men, drew up the Yakumo Party cabinet policy. The heat of factional politics eventually broke down the Union 7. It was like a warm welcome in the world of politics. It became clear to me then. This country didn't have what it took to compete with the rest of the world.
It must be wonderful to have such a bright secretary.
Not as bright as you, Mr. Smith. Thank
God. Hand over the Yakumo.
Lady, where are your manners?
the United States. Interesting. Got nothing better to do anyway. Whenever I see a punk, the assassin starts to stir. From here, it's all about enjoying myself. Sure you got the balls for a shootout? Dead or alive, you're going down. You won't last a single minute of chaos in me. Better get ready to die. Yakumo will destroy your country. Back off before you get hurt.